Now Wade. No look down into Bosch behind the back. Inside Whiteside. What a play. Wade down to Bosch behind the back. And the big man is the benefactor there with a two-hand jam.
Hello and welcome to our NBA team preview, Miami Heat. I'm Vince Cellini. After four straight trips to the NBA Finals, the Heat weren't used to simply being given a participation trophy. But that's exactly what happened last year, missing the postseason entirely without LeBron James. But the good news for Miami is on the health front, especially regarding Chris Bosh, who played in a career-low 44 games due to blood clots in his lungs. Bosh is ready to roll now for a 13th season. And the Heat also has a full season with the Dragon. Goran Dragic signing a five-year, $90 million contract in the offseason. He's tough, he's talented, he's Miami's quarterback. Plus, there is new blood in the person of rookie Justice Winslow, falling to Miami in the draft at 10th overall, strong and fast with a championship pedigree in college. Let's hear now from the Heat's head coach and their undisputed leader. And it goes all the way back to the impact of LeBron James' departure.
Last year happened very fast. Our team changed dramatically, as we know, in July. And we had to scramble and try to put together a team that could compete still at the highest level. Every year I've worked for this organization, for Mickey Arison and Pat Riley, the goal has always been to put together a team that will compete for a title. And that wasn't any different last year. We weren't able to accomplish that, but we learned a lot. And we were able to go through a lot of adversities together, things we would have done differently, things I would have done differently. But ultimately, we didn't get the job done.
I'm very excited to have a healthy team, you know, to start the season off. You know, we knock on wood and we hope that, you know, we can be, you know, healthy all season long. But, you know, to look to the left and the right and knowing that, you know, not only is our starting five good, but we got depth on our bench by the veterans that we've added with Gerald, with Amari, with Josh now, you know, being healthy, et cetera. It makes us feel good coming into this year, you know, that we have, you know, the team that we need to compete. And now we just got to put it together. We got to mix all the ingredients together. Hopefully we come out with a gourmet meal.
Dwayne Wade knows what he wants. Can he get it from Goran Dragic? The two of them meshing together, each having the ball at times, is going to be key. Also, Dragic and Bosh have yet to play a regular season game together. With more, let's send it over to our all-star analysts, Steve Smith and Brian Shaw. Fellas.
Thanks, Vince. The word in South Beach, Brian, is pace, pace, pace. I want to ask you a question from a coaching standpoint from Coach Spoelstra. You talk about they want to pick up the pace. I won't call them older guys. They have some veteran guys. How do you have your teammate buy into want to play faster, and do they have the personnel to run?
Well, I think you have to make the commitment in training camp and throughout the preseason to put in the conditioning work if you want to actually play at a faster pace. I think last year they finished it, they were 29th in pace as a team. And, you know, as these guys are aging, not only are they aging, but they have a lot of wear and tear, you know, going deep into the playoffs for all the years that they did. So that commitment to conditioning and playing at a faster pace, that's going to be the question. Also, the willingness of Spoelstra to allow a looser shot selection. When you're getting up and down the floor, you know, you want to take the first available good shot that's there. And, you know, are you going to be willing to do that as a coach who has basically kind of controlled things? They played a lot in the half-court set. You're also going to give up a lot more points defensively because there's going to be more possessions in the game. So that question is, you know, are they going to make that commitment conditioning-wise? And then, you know, with the wear and tear on Wade, Bosh, Lou Aldang, you know, and some of the players that they have, Amari Stoudemire, are they going to be able and willing to do that?
And speaking of Wade, I look at Dwayne Wade as a guy. Him and Dragic both need the basketball. I think this year of having chemistry, both guys, I think Dwayne Wade, I don't think he'll play 82 games, but I look at him being very productive around 65, maybe 70 games. The one thing I love about him is, yes, his athleticism is not where he used to be, but he understands the game. He has a high basketball IQ. And people ask, are you done? Just look at those numbers. He averaged 21 points, shot close to 48, 47%. I think him and Dragic together can play better than they played last year.
Definitely. You know, they have a half a season kind of under their belt now. They'll get used to being able to pick their spots on the floor and during the game when each one of them kind of has the ball and takes over. I think that, you know, for Wade at the point in career, in his career where he is right now, the game is slowed down for him. So his footwork, fundamentals, and things like that will help allow him to create space and get to where he needs to get on the floor. I just, you know, I think that they're going to have to play two different styles with two different units. I think they're going to have a pace and more of a flow with that first unit. Mm-hmm. And then with the second unit, with Chalmers, Gerald Green, Justice Winslow, McRoberts, and Stoudemire, they should be able to get up and down a little bit more, create some things defensively to try to get some easier baskets in transition.
And right now, we're going to take a closer look at Goran Dragic, the Dragon, what he brings to the team. And let's run this Higo. First of all, watching him right here on pick and roll, he does a nice job of creating some separation, a nice pass, putting it right in the pocket for Amari Stoudemire. And yes, the veteran still has some young legs. Not every trip, but a couple trips down the court, he'll be able to dunk the basketball. What I do love about Dragic is he's strong enough and he can create his own offense and get to the basket. He drives the basketball. And we go back to what you talked about, Bryant. Pace. Bosh and D-Wade. Look at the two old fellas committing to getting out and running, and Dwayne Wade finishing. I love Dragic because we talked about pace. They were 30th in the league before the All-Star break. They still finished 29th, but after All-Star break with Goran Dragic, they were 21st in the league. Considering pace, they played a little bit faster with Goran Dragic.
Well, it's great to have Chris Bosh back, one of the good people in the game. And obviously, you want to aim high if you're Miami, because that's where they were for so many years. But Bishaw, tell me about having him back and his contributions and versatility, what he means for this team.
Well, they only had him for 44 games last year, which is a career low for him. So having that consistent guy who shoots a high percentage from the field, shoots a decent percentage from the three-point line, and good free-throw shooter as well. Somebody that's going to space the floor for them, but can play inside as well. I think it's going to benefit Hassan Whiteside because it's going to give him more space to operate inside when they do get the ball inside. But just having that veteran presence, somebody who's been there and done that, and I think he has a chip on his shoulder and something to prove. You know, this is going to really be his first, hopefully, full season post-LeBron James, and he wants to prove that. He was an all-star star for years in Toronto before he came to Miami, and that the Miami Heat can still get to the finish line without Superman LeBron being there.
And post-big contract for him, that first big contract year. But, Smitty, again, wonderful to have him back, a stabilizer and a leader for this team, obviously.
It is. I mean, you love Chris Bosh and everything he went through. Happy to see him being able to return to basketball, because no one wants the game taken away from him. He's so versatile. He can do so many different things. What I love is he's a guy that – you can count on him in big games and big plays. Now getting a chance to team up with Hassan Whiteside. Interesting to see him play more of a four position right now. But with Whiteside, like Brian said, he'll create more opportunities for him because of his spacing and his knowledge of the game. But Whiteside, to me, is one of those guys, Brian, that in 48 games he played with the Heat, he started 32. He has some games where he just totally dominated the league. Next step for him is being consistent and being able to play 82 games and play major minutes and playing with others. Now you have Dwayne Wade, you'll have Dragic and Bosh, along with Lowell Dang. But you talk about a guy ended up averaging 12 points, 10 rebounds, and 2.6 block shots. I mean, he's 7 feet. He's old school. This is no stretch five. This is all low post Hassan Whiteside doing the dirty work. And he shot about 63%. 95% of those were dunks. So looking forward to seeing those guys match up, because they'll be really big. You talk about small ball, right, having Whiteside and Bosh. That goes back to old school with me and
Brian. That's pretty big.
That's 7 feet, 6'11".
Well, Whiteside was one of the great stories of last season as far as how he played. But one of the other things is, and Brian, you're big on this, controlling his emotions. He's going to have to get that in check as well.
And I think that's where he'll benefit from having Bosh back as well, somebody who's a veteran that can be in his ear and kind of help control him a little bit out there on the floor. And with his maturation, you know, having another year under his belt, hopefully he'll get better in that area. But, you know, one of the things that kind of gets lost in all this pace talk about the Miami Heat is that, like I said, there's going to be more possessions. You're going to give up more points because you're playing more possessions. Whiteside gives them an anchor on the defensive side and a rim protector so that they can get stops and then hopefully get out in transition and get some easy baskets.
And this is a contract year for him as well. Oh, but just by the way, we talked about Amari Stoudemire joining this team and Josh McRoberts. Dennis asked Chris Bosch about that as well. McRoberts only played 17 games, had that knee injury, but his impact as well for a full season is going to be enormous.
You know, I think for fans out there, a lot of people know about Josh McRoberts, but you're talking about a guy, when you look at Josh McRoberts is a guy that can high flyer, can play without the basketball, but I look at him as a point guard in a point in a power forward position. He wants to handle the basketball and make plays, and he's pretty good at that. Then he can shoot the three, so I think the versatility of playing him alongside Whiteside, alongside Chris Bosh, gives Spoelstra a guy that he knows that can come in and create plays and have another guy to take the pressure off of Dragic, take a pressure off Dwayne Wade of making plays.
Which I also think has got to be big in terms of pace. If you want to play that way, they have a big guy that can handle the ball. Like
yeah,
that.
Definitely. You know, he can get the ball off the board, push it, and start initiate their break. But one of the things that you've seen kind of be trend in the NBA now is having big players in the playmaker position, playing out off the elbows and being able to go on dribble handoffs and make decisions of handing the ball off, being able to make nice little drop passes to guards going back door. And that's something that Josh McRoberts can do really well. And having him for a full season, as well as the rest of the guys that have been injured and banged up, and having a little bit more depth in their lineup now should do good things for the Heat.
We talked about Bosch maybe having a chip on his shoulder. What about Amari Stoudemire, who gets another reset for his career, although he's been a fine player, you know, a change of scenery for him?
Well, I think he, you know, with Amari Stoudemire, I think the key word is efficient. And I think that maybe less is more. You know, I don't think that you're going to get a ton of minutes out of him. He's had injury problems in the past as well. But, yeah, a chance for him to kind of redeem himself and reestablish the kind of player that he is. And as he's slowed down a little bit through injuries, wear and tear, just being able to pick his times on the floor where he can be effective and do the things that he brings to the table.